But they didn't have any faith in God. Whatever the case, when you trust totally and completely in God, you never have to fear the enemy. Amen?
Amen.
Even though some tribes didn't respond to Deborah, many of the men of her tribe and others came to her aid. And that's a good lesson. See, when we get in trouble, when we're in need, we find out who will really come to our aid. Amen?
Amen.
We find out who our real friends are.
Amen.
Like the old saying, a friend in need is a friend what?
Indeed.
Indeed. Psalms 46:1 says, God is our refuge.
Yes.
God is our very present help in the time of trouble. Now let's go down to verse 6, Judges 4:6. Then she sent and called for Barak, the son of Abinoam, from Kadesh in Naphtali, and said to him, has not the Lord God of Israel commanded? Go and deploy troops at Mount Tabor. Take with you 10,000 men of the sons of Naphtali and the sons of Zebulun. And against you I will deploy Sisera, the commander of Jabin's army, with his chariots and with his multitude at the river Kishon. And God said, and I will deliver him into your hand. And Barak said unto her, if you will go with me, then I'll go. But if you will not go with me, I will not go. Now, was Barak a coward, or did he just need some moral support? I don't know. The Bible doesn't say, but I do know this. He was dependent on Deborah to hear from God.
Right.
You know, a lot of people come and ask you to pray for them because they don't believe God hears their prayer. Amen. But you got to know that if you belong to him,
right,
you can hear from God. He said, my sheep hear my voice. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Verse 9 says, so she said, I will surely go with you. Nevertheless, there will be no glory for you in the journey you are taking, for the Lord will sell Sisera into the hand of a woman. Then Deborah rose and went with Barak to Kadesh. Now Deborah was a great leader. She followed God's directions. Her personality demanded respect, even of Barak, and he was a big-time military general, but his trust was in her. Her trust was totally in God. Not only did she obey God, but she encouraged her people to obey him as well. What about you? Are you encouraging those around you to obey God?
Oh, yeah.
Do you witness to those people that are in your circle of influence? And you can witness by your lifestyle. You don't have to say a word sometimes. Just live right before people. Amen?
Amen.
Tell people about the love and the goodness of the Lord. See, every chance we get, we need to B-O-G. We need to brag on God. Because God is so good. Look at verse 10. Judges 4:10. And Barak called Zebulun and Naphtali to Kadesh. He went up with 10,000 men under his command, and Deborah went up with him. Skip down to verse 13. So Sisera gathered together all his chariots, 900 chariots of iron. That's a lot of chariots. And all the people who were with him from Harosheth to the river Kishon. Verse 14, then Deborah said to Barak, ah, for this is the day in which the Lord has delivered Sisera into your hand. Has not the Lord gone out before you? She's a brave woman, wasn't she?
Right.
So Barak went down from Mount Tabor with 10,000 men following him. See, Deborah had gathered up 10,000 men when she went against Jabin's army. Sisera was the leader of Jabin's army, and he was just as evil as Jabin was. His 900 chariots were made of iron and wood, and they were pulled by two or three horses. And these chariots were the most feared weapons of the day. See, some of the chariots, and I don't know if you ever seen the movies like with Hercules and all of them, the chariots, they would have razor sharp knives in the wheels. And when the wheels would turn and they would charge into the people, the knives would cut the people to death. What a horrible way to die. Now Israel didn't stand a chance against this powerful army until Deborah called out to God for help. See, things may be looking pretty bad for you sometimes, but God. Amen?
Amen.
The doctors may not be able to help you anymore, but God.
But God.
You may not be able to make your mortgage payment or your rent payment, but God.
But God.
Amen. One word from God can change your whole situation. Amen?
Amen.
One word.
One word.
One word from Jesus, and Peter walked on water.
Amen.
He said, that be you bid me to come.
Come
Jesus
on.
Said, yeah, baby, this me. Come. And Peter became a water-walking disciple.
Amen. Amen.
One word be to God.
Right now.
One word from God.
Right now.
Now, Sisera thought that his great army, his 900 chariots, would cause the Israelites and Deborah, who was just a woman, mind you, to run from him. See, he couldn't see that God was with Deborah and her people. Amen? And if God be for you, who can be against you? God is our deliverer. He is a very present help in the time of trouble. David said in Psalms 118:6, the Lord is on my side, I will not fear. What can man do to me? Deborah also, she had God on her side, but she also had the weather on her side. A violent and terrible rainstorm came down suddenly on the battlefield. And suddenly it started to rain. See, this wasn't a coincidence, this was a God incident. The rainstorm was part of God's plan to give Deborah the victory. See, God doesn't just give us his whole plan at once. And I'm so glad he doesn't, because we'd be trying to tell God how to do it.
Right.
Amen.
Yeah.
But he makes us walk it out step by step so that we can learn to lean and confidently trust in him for the next thing that he tells us to do. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says that Abraham staggered not at the promises of God through unbelief. He was fully persuaded that what God had promised, he was able to perform. Amen?
Amen.
So if God tells you something, he will hasten that word to perform it. According to Jeremiah, another version says, I am ready to perform my word. Deborah simply had to trust God, and she did. We have to do the same thing. We have to trust in the Lord with all our heart and lean not to our own understanding. In all our ways, not some of them, in all our ways we are to acknowledge him, and he promised to direct our path. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.